I wanted to discuss, and I haven't, Mr. Chairman. I had the opportunity. I was out a couple of weeks ago, and it was my understanding that there was a motion and a vote about hiring new employees. And I understand that we've got an elected body of our employment body through the town clerk, and I understand those positions would rightfully go to a town warrant. But could we rediscuss that notion that it's my understanding that any new employees, and I hope I'm wrong on this, in the town of Hampton have to be put on the town warrant. Is that correct?
Full-time employees.
And I would just say this on that, and I think
you want to make a motion to revisit that because
I would like to have this discussion because and then I'll make my motion about it because I wasn't here, and I think that's a substantial diminution and restriction of the selectman's statutory authority to lead in the prudential and execution of the prudential affairs under the RSA. I'm on the New Hampshire Municipal Association website right now, and there are tort cases that selectmen can actually do that, and I think that does that. And whether we're here for 4 more months or 6 more years or 10 more years, it is a very restrictive provision. And I think the appropriate way for that to go, I think the cart is before the horse. If the townspeople have so little confidence in a board, that in some exigent manner or an emergency management issue and a police issue that happens and we have to wait for 15 months or 12 months or 14 months to hire somebody on a $26 million corporation. We just heard the explanation of the audit. It's a huge corporation. I think that hamstrings the people, and the people are in charge of this town. We work for the people. We work for the citizens, not the taxpayers. Taxpayers for sure, but for the citizens. They empower us at the polls and when they vote for us to make these decisions. And they have our confidence, or they vote us out, or we leave. But I think it's a restriction of our statutory authority. I think we act in the best interests of the town. There are employment executions and decisions we've made as a board together in bringing somebody up when we had a sudden onset and a sudden death and retweaked a position that I think has been fabulous for this town. And we would not be able to do that. And sometimes there's some great talent that moves up the ranks through our departments, and they go elsewhere, and they're going to be gone forever, and they're never going to come back. So I do think it is a restriction. There's precedent in the New Hampshire Municipal Association, and I think if the townspeople want to put that as a warrant article, then they have every right to do that, and that should be a warrant article put out by a petition. But for us to unilaterally restrict that, I think, is in violation of the spirit of the ordinance and the confidence that people have. So I don't know the exact motion that it would be, but I would say that we certainly don't have to go through a warrant to hire one person in a $26 million corporation. And if someone is here that made that motion, or someone that wants to make that motion that participated in that, that's fine. I'll defer to that. If not, I will. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
I want to say, I thought we made a motion that all new positions, not new hires, not all full-time employees.
Yeah, positions. Any new position would go on a warrant article.
And I would like to bring up how what happens, for instance, let's use the town clerk. If we put it in the budget and then the budget fails, then she gets nothing. And in the past, and I'm not blaming her, but this is how other people have done it, they hedge their bets and then they do their own warrant article besides. Okay. So, you know, I don't, if that's the way it's going to be, I would just assume, you know, I don't know. I think it needs to be one way or the other. The voters need to have a say, and they're put into double jeopardy. Is the budget going to fail because of that? And I see how it works, and I wish everyone the best. But we have to, you know, that's. a problem that's been faced over and over again, and I guess it's going to remain that way by the sound of it.
And if I could just have one more comment, and that'll be all, Mr. Chairman, is I won't make any motion tonight, but I did want to revisit it, and I think an example is Mr. Sullivan. We would not have been able to do that. We created a new position as assistant town manager and personnel director, and we've got tremendous bang for our buck in terms of a lifelong tenured emergency response, first responder, chief of police for the town of Hampton, a labor expert, a negotiations expert, human resource expert, second command. If anything, God forbid, ever happens to a leadership here, he can step in a moment's notice. We could not have done that, and he would be elsewhere. So I won't make any motion tonight, but it's for consideration. We might come up again, and thank you for your time, Mr. Chairman.